Hi friends, Angular has recently added a cool feature called Signals. It helps make your app faster by understanding exactly what data changes need updates. Signals are becoming a popular choice in the Angular world. I have already uploaded a video on Signals. If you are new to Signals, that video will definitely help you to learn it easily. Recently, Angular team has introduced inputs as signals, model inputs, and queries as signals. In this video, I'm going to explain how we can make use of these features. Let's start. Usually, we use input and output decorators to communicate between parent and child components. But in this approach, we do have some limitations. Let me explain. I have created this simple application. Here, I have an input component. In this, I have an input box which accepts a number and a button. On clicking this button, I'm calling a function. To this function, I'm passing this number input. And inside this function, I'm getting the value of the input and assigning it to a variable. Also, I have a child component. To this child component, I'm passing this value. In the child component, I'm getting this value and calculating its square value and showing in the HTML. But if I enter any number and click the calculate button, it will not work, because the result has been already calculated before this value has been changed. If I default it here, we can see the calculated value. But if I change, it won't recalculate. So once we click the button, we need to emit an event and capture that event in the child component and recalculate this result. Or we can use a behavior subject to notify this child component and we need to recalculate this result again. Otherwise, we can implement the ng-onChanges lifecycle hook and calculate this result again. Like this. Now this will work. Also, one more challenge is, here we need to initialize this. If you are not doing this, it will throw error. Otherwise, we need to use the exclamation mark like this. But this is not the good way. Both of these can be solved by converting this to a signal. I can convert this to a signal and this to a computed signal like this. I don't want the ng-onChanges. Let me comment that. And in template also, let me change this to a signal. But now in input component, we got an error because we cannot bind the signal to this. So here, instead of a normal signal, we can create this as an input signal. Now we can bind this in our parent component. So whenever there is a change in the parent component value, the child component will be notified and the result will be recalculated. Okay. Let's see about model inputs. Before that, I request you to give a like to this video. That will help me a lot. Thanks. Okay. Here, I have created a checkbox component. The value of this checkbox is coming from its parent component through input decorator. In the parent component, I have a button to toggle this value. Also, I'm showing another div dynamically based on this checkbox value. In the checkbox component also, I'm having a click event and toggling this value. So we can see using this button, we can toggle this checkbox. This div is also getting toggled. But if I click in the checkbox, we are seeing the checkbox is getting toggled, but the div is not getting toggled. If I show this value in the template, we can see the value is getting changed, but the dynamic div is not getting toggled. That is because in this checkbox component, we are just receiving this value as input. We are not using any output decorator to emit this value back to the parent component. But instead of that, we can do this efficiently using model inputs. Let me change this to a model input. And so, here we need to change. As model input is writable, we can update this. Also in the template, we need to change this. Now as this is a model input, this will also propagate the value back to the parent component. To receive that, we need to use the two-way binding syntax here. That's it. Now we can see it is working. Okay, let's see about queries as signals. This feature is still in developer preview and according to the Angular documentation, there may be changes in the APIs. So let me explain this in very high level. Once this becomes stable, I will create a separate video in detail. Okay, in this component, I have a text box and a button. On clicking this button, I want to focus this text box. For that, I have used a template reference variable and I am using ViewChild to get reference to that element. And then inside the focus function, I'm using nativeElement.focus to focus the text box. So if I click the button, we can see text box is getting focused. Let me show you how we can change this to signal. First, let me create the signal variable like this. And in the focus section, let me change this to a signal. Now if I test this, we can see it is working. Also, if you have used any component here, we can easily get the reference like this. Usually, we use ViewChild, ViewChildren, ContentChild and ContentChildren to query the DOM. And we have signal APIs available for all of these. Anyways, like I said before, we will see them in a separate video once this feature becomes stable. Hope you understood how we can use the signal inputs, model inputs and queries as signals. If you like this video, please subscribe and support me. Post your valuable comments in the comment section. I'll be back with another interesting concept soon. Thank you. Bye.